rectal bleeding is a very common clinical condition of seeing blood in your stools. You can see a small amount of blood after you open your bowels, or you can see a lot of blood. If you see a lot of blood or passage of clots from the back passage area, that is a clinical emergency and you should seek emergency medical help. However, the vast majority of presentations are usually a small amounts of blood after you pass your motions in the pan or on the toilet paper. Because it's embarrassing, it is underreported, but it is thought that at least every third individual will see some blood from his back passage area throughout his lifetime. Being a very common but embarrassing condition, a lot of people seek self-treatment and self-diagnosis, which can be dangerous because it can sometimes masquerade clinically serious conditions. So I would recommend that though it is a common condition, it is worthwhile seeking medical attention when you see blood in your stools. Rectal bleeding can be caused by any condition that potentially bleeds inside the lumen of the gut. It is usually due to hemorrhoids, that is the vast majority of the cases, but it can also be due to a fissure in ano. It can be due to colitis, it can be due to diverticular disease, or rarely this could be a presentation of colonic cancer, especially in the rectal area. It is important that we do not self-diagnose hemorrhoids, though they are the common cause, as the other serious conditions may then get delayed in their presentation and diagnosis. Rectal bleeding, that is usually after passing blood which is bright red in color, painless, is happening only once in a blue moon, usually is due to hemorrhoids. However, if you notice dark red blood, if the bleeding is painful, if you notice a change in bowel pattern associated with your bleeding, especially if it is diarrhea, or you notice anything that is causing you concern, you should seek medical attention. Hemorrhoids are a very common condition. We all have anal cushions normally, but when these start prolapsing out, these can get irritated when we pass motions and then they bleed. The bleeding is typically bright red in color, fresh in nature, and this should stain the toilet paper and be a splash in the pan. There is a huge amount of embarrassment about hemorrhoids purely because people try to self-treat them with a lot of medication that is available. However, I would recommend that you seek medical help because they can be very easily treated with either an injection, a rubber band ligation, or rarely a hemorrhoidopexy operation, all of which are painless options. It is now rare for us to do the painful old-style hemorrhoidectomy, which is now reserved for very severe cases alone. Colon cancer is again a very, very common condition. It is the second most common cancer which affects men and women, especially in their 60s. It is, however, a treatable and actually a preventable cancer. In the US, it is recommended that we do a colonoscopy at the age of 55 to look for polyps, which usually are not having any symptoms. However, even if we pick up early cancers, there is almost a 95% chance of cure with surgery and or chemo and radiotherapy. We would prefer to pick up cancers early, as advanced cancers have a much poorer prognosis. So I would always recommend that pay attention to your colonic symptoms, especially bleeding or change in your bowel pattern, and seek medical help when it is important. First of all, do not panic. Rectal bleeding is quite common. Just watch whether this was a bright red blood once in a blue moon and on the toilet paper. If that is the case, you preferably can wait a few days to see whether it's persisting, especially if you have no other symptoms to go with it. However, the main reason why hemorrhoids bleed is because they prolapse out. So avoiding excessive straining, making sure your stools are soft enough to pass, drinking adequate water, having a healthy fiber component in your diet, all are simple measures which will prevent you from getting hemorrhoidal bleeding and will also potentially prevent a lot of other colonic conditions which present as bleeding. So I would always recommend a healthy diet, regular exercise, and avoiding straining of defecation.